It's a nice day and we're in a terrific coastal location. This is Southport. What better way to learn about the coast as it is and the way it was than this museum, the North Carolina Maritime Museum here in Southport. This is Amy Williams. She's the historic interpreter here at the museum, and this is really cool. And you're going to tell us all about pirates?
Well, I'd like to tell you some other things about the museum as well. We have 2,000 years of natural and cultural history of the Lower Cape Fear region here, including this natural history exhibit on sharks and megalodon.
Sharks and megalodon teeth, that's something to think about when you go swimming. What about this collection you've got here?
We have a collection of one family's 20 years collecting shark's teeth on the beach.
Wow.
So over several generations, they found these out on Oak Island. We also have this megalodon tooth that was discovered while diving on Shark's Tooth Ledge. And this one we let people handle. We let people touch it so they can see how heavy it is and how gigantic the shark would have been. 1 inch of tooth, you get 10 feet of shark.
Wow, I'm gonna think about that when I find these on the beach. These shark's teeth are all over the beaches of North Carolina and a lot of coastal areas. They're easy and fun to find.
We have loggerhead sea turtles that nest on Oak Island, just down the road from here. So people protect these hatchlings, and we have gone from maybe 1 out of 1,000 hatchlings making it to adulthood to more like 100 out of 1,000 hatchlings making it to adulthood.
Here we are in the pirate room. I know it's my favorite, but lots of people really like this stuff. Tell us about the display you have here at the museum.
Well, we do tend to focus on the Lower Cape Fear region pirates.
Of course.
Talk about the major pirate who came here, you know, Blackbeard. Blackbeard, who spent a little time on Oak Island and Bald Head Island. He used to wait for ships to crash on Frying Pan Shoals, and then he would hover there and take items from whatever he could pillage.
He was plundering.
That's right. We talk about him, his raging appetite for destruction, and we also talk about his sort of the archetype or the opposite of him, the other Cape Fear pirate of this region.
Steve Bonnet.
Steve Bonnet, of course, the gentleman.
Gentleman pirate. Now that's kind of a contrast in terms there.
That's right, you would think so. He started pirating about the same time as Blackbeard, and he and Blackbeard ran together for a little while. Blackbeard thought he was so hokey because he bought his ship, Steve Bonnet paid for his ship, had a library on board, and dressed like, as Blackbeard called him, a dandy. Which meant he wore breeches and gentleman's shoes and a jacket instead of the typical gun belt of weapons and things like that, like Blackbeard had.
Of course, there's more than one way to shoot a pirate. And Southport is also home to the Steve Bonnet Regatta, which is much more of a party than a race.
It was a good race.
Why was it good?
Light wind at the beginning, heavy wind at the end. You know, boats sliding into boats, fiberglass on fiberglass violence isn't bad. A lot of rum abuse, but besides that, it was pretty natural.
It's always a bribe.
Did the bribe work?
Yes,
it always worked.
The sun goes down. The wackos come out, the rum flows.
I like the perks, the wine, the rum, the friends, the party. It's all good.
Hey, I'm James Capps, captain of Daddy's Girl sailing vessel. We did finish ahead of a few boats, but not very many.
What was the strategy for your crew today?
Leave clean without hitting anyone and return safely. That was our plan.
And you figured you did that?
We did do that. It was close a few times, but we did manage to pull that off.
Good.
We sported 7 kids under the age of 16.
Nice.
And so we were probably the youngest crew involved. We had a great time, yes sir.
Did you race today?
We did race today. We crossed the finish line before other boats. Does that count?
Yeah.
The wind was a little nil in the beginning, but then we had a little puff of brew wind to bring us around the first mark, and then we got a little energized, but then the wind died again, and we had strategy number two. That didn't work so well either, but we did cross the finish line before other boats. Best part about being a pirate in Southport, living in Southport.
The Steed Bonnet Regatta is a lot of fun, and it takes place right here in Southport right around Halloween. What a coincidence. We also want to thank our friends at the North Carolina Maritime Museum. This location here in Southport, they're also located in Beaufort and Hatteras. Check out their website for more information.